Good morning, students. This lesson is of class 5th for the subject of Geography, Chapter 19, Industries, which we will continue from page number 119 of your textbook, titled Time Trek, Book 5. And is being submitted to you on 25th January 2021. This voice is of Millie Bhatnagar. In the previous lecture, we had studied about the meaning of an industry and the factors responsible for its growth. The raw material, power, transport, machinery, human resource, and money are required for the growth of the industries. On the basis of size, industries are of three types. Number one, large-scale industries consist of heavy power-driven machines. They involve thousands of laborers and huge capital investments, that is, a huge amount of money. A complex management system controls these type of industries. They obtain raw materials from distant regions, and the production is on a mass scale. The most suitable example of large-scale industries are iron and steel, textiles, oil refineries, and automobile. Small-scale industries. As compared to large-scale industries, they employ small number of workforce and limited capital, that is, money. Raw materials are purchased from outside, and finished goods are sold through a network of traders. Generally, individuals own small-scale industries. The main products of small-scale industries are utensils, leather goods, furniture, cycles, clothes, etc. Students, this is an image of leather goods industry. Manufacture of cycles and furniture. Cottage industries. They are also known as household or village industries. These industries are commonly found in rural areas. The work is done by craftsmen and artisans belonging to the same family. The products like pottery, jewelry, handicraft, ivory products, and handlooms are made for local markets. These industries promote employment in the villages. Students, this is an image of a pottery. And this of handicraft. Let us take a short break. You are requested to kindly pause this recording for 3 to 4 minutes after listening to the questions carefully and write the answers in your notebooks. Question number one, give two examples of cottage industries. Question number two, what are large scale industries? Question number three, give examples of small scale industries. We will now discuss the answers. Number one, pottery and jewelry. Number two, large scale industries consist of heavy power driven machine using industries involving thousands of laborers and a huge amount of money. Number three, utensils, leather goods, cycles, clothes. We will continue with our lecture and study about information technology industry. The science which uses computers and software to manage information is information technology. The programs used in a computer are called softwares, and the computer machine is called hardware. Information technology in modern age has made the transferring of information from one place to another very convenient. Information technology has not only brought positive changes in all spheres of life, but also in various sectors like healthcare and education. Chennai, Hyderabad, and Bengaluru are some of the major centers of this industry in India. Finally, we will deal here with the business process outsourcing, which involves using a third-party provider company for any business process that could otherwise be done in-house. So, BPO is the business strategy where one company hires another company to perform a certain task for them. That is, they outsource a certain job. Students, please read the chapter carefully and complete the following home assignment. Fill in the blanks 1, 2, and 3. State whether these statements are true or false. 1, 2, and 3. With this, we end this interactive audio session. Thank you.